what do you want to see out of tonight? What would be a successful night to you?
Winning will be successful tonight. But just, you know, playing the right way, I think. Transition defense, you know, defensively getting back because they are the number one team in transition. Moving the basketball, you know, playing together, playing with pace. And that would be a start. But for the most part, I just think, you know, working IT back, you know, it's been tough because he had a minute restriction. And then, you know, he's going back playing with the second unit when they had a good rhythm going. And then so now his minutes are starting to increase. So it's just been, a tough time just trying to, you know, figure out the minutes and get him off the floor at the right time and different combinations. But, you know, we'll figure it out.
Do you still feel like you're the best team in the East?
Yeah.
Why?
Because we got the best player in the world.
Down front, Joe.
Joe Vardon, Cleveland.com. You mentioned that IT's minutes were extending. Is he still on some kind of restriction?
Yes, sir.
He said yesterday that he knew he would struggle like this shooting, and I think you've said the same thing that there'd be nights. How do you feel he's moving?
I think he's moving pretty good. I think, you know, it's just mental. Like, you know, the first two games I thought, you know, was good, but I thought it was fool's gold because he'd been out for so long. But the adrenaline, he really played well. And I just think, you know, after that, you know, I think you start playing in thought. You can't play fast and play with speed and play with pace when you're playing in thought. And I think that's been his biggest thing. You know, missing easy shots, coming off pick and rolls when he's open, not shooting it, and, you know, going too deep at times. But that just all comes from timing and playing more games and getting that down. So I feel good about it.
I mean, we've seen, you know, when anyone thinks of great IT, you know, they picture those, you know, flashing through the lane and blowing by people and stopping on a dime. Could he do that right now physically?
Yes. And to answer your question, Jason, in a better light, we're not right now, but we will be the best team in the East, yes. Thank you.
You think about that?
I mean, well, we're not playing the best right now, but we will be. Yes, sir.
Chris. I already tweeted what you said.
That's right. I know you did. So retweet that. We're not the best right now, but we will be at some point.
Chris Haynes, ESPN. You've been with this team last 4 years. You've seen the ups and downs that you guys tend to go through at certain points through the season. Is anything about this year being different from any experiences that you dealt with team?
Well, the difference is we have new pieces and new players. I think that's the biggest thing. And then, you know, I got to give our guys credit. You know, the players that we had, and, you know, with Rose being out the whole year, with IT being out the whole year, and just figuring it out. And, you know, just staying afloat until those guys got back. They've done a hell of a job, you know, so we can't be mad about that. But now we just got to figure it out and continue to keep, you know, working like we're doing every single day to get better. And that's all you can ask.
Is there any similarities to you guys brought in Shump and Mostoff and JR. Can you go back to that as far as experience on how it was?
That was different. But I mean, then I wasn't coaching either. But it was, you know, we were struggling, and then bringing in Timo and JR and Shump, just, you know, we just shook things up, and I thought they really brought a big difference to our team. And I think after that, going 33-5 when we acquired those guys when everyone was healthy. So, you know, that was something kind of jolted our season. So, you know, we'll see what happens.
Chris Fedor, Cleveland.com. I don't want to put words in your mouth, but it sounds like you anticipated these kinds of struggles trying to integrate IT. Is that fair to say?
It's very fair to say. And I mean, when players are on many restrictions and, you know, you can't really do what you want to do with those guys, it's different because the lineups change. He can't really sit out for too long. You got to get him back in. So then he's playing with the second year. So it's just a combination of things, but it's no excuse. I mean, it's a great problem to have. You know, once he gets back to, you know, being IT, you know, 100% far as playing wise, everything will be fine.
Jeff Shadell, News Herald. Ty, you mentioned it yesterday at practice, but talk about being back here at the Q, where you guys have won 13 in a row.
It's great. You know, I think, you know, we have some of the best fans in the world. And, you know, we just talked about how our fans, when you come here to Cleveland, they're cheering for Cleveland. Like, it's not like a lot of teams where you go on the road and they're cheering for you. They're cheering for the Cavs. And it's just great to be back. You know, in our building, like you said, we won 13 in a row. We played well. We haven't been shooting the ball well. But, you know, coming back home, I think it's going to be a positive thing for us. So I'm just happy to be back.